Hi everyone, myself Manoj, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. Let's continue with the first law of thermodynamics problem. In the previous part, we have gone through the constant pressure problem, and here we are going to solve the adiabatic problem. So for adiabatic process, the specific formula has given for the adiabatic process, polytropic process, etc. Remember, for the adiabatic process, there will not be any heat transfer taking place. So therefore, the heat transfer Q for the adiabatic process is equal to zero. The initial volume of 0.18 kilogram of acetone gas was 0.15 meter cube. And at a temperature of 15 degrees centigrade and a pressure of 100 kilonewton per meter square. The initial volume V1 is equal to 0.15 meter cube as given. And the initial volume of 0.18 kilogram of a certain gas, that means it given as a mass in kilogram, 0.18 kilogram. And a temperature of 15 degrees centigrade. The temperature as given, T1 is equal to 15 degrees centigrade. So you have to convert it into kelvins by adding 273. T1 is equal to 288 kelvin. And a pressure of 100 kilonewton per meter square. Therefore, the initial pressure given is 100 kilonewton per meter square. After adiabatic compression. So remember this word, adiabatic compression. The compression is always compression and expansion taking place adiabatically. So while compressing or expanding any system, we won't bother about the heat transfer. Therefore, the compression and expansion is always happening in the adiabatic process alone. So here they have given the adiabatic compression. So for everything, drawing the pressure volume diagram, which gives more confident to solve the problem. After the adiabatic compression, the pressure and volume was found to be 400 kilonewton per meter square. When it after adiabatically compressed, the pressure is P2 is equal to 400 kilonewton per meter square. Due to the compression, the pressure gets increased and the volume is 0.056 meter cube. So as I already told you, the pressure, when the pressure increases, the volume decreases and vice versa. Since the pressure is always inversely proportional to its volume. Find the first question, the ratio of the specific heats, gamma. Gamma is equal to Cp divided by Cv, the ratio of specific heats. Second one, change in internal energy. Right, here the given process is adiabatic process. First, you have to mention the process, this problem belongs to which process. Therefore, I can write this problem belongs to the adiabatic compression. After taking all the data, I'm going to apply the equations. First, for finding the ratio of specific heat gamma, I need to find the value of R. That means gas constant. For finding the gas constant, we can use the gas equation. That is PV is equal to MRT is a gas equation, which is derived from the characteristic gas equation called PV divided by T is equal to constant. For the constant, we have had the gas constant R. PV by T is equal to R. So by considering the value of mass, that is PV by T is equal to MR. Therefore, PV is equal to M into R into T. As we have studied in the previous problems, where P1 is given in the problem, the pressure, the initial pressure of 100 kilonewton per meter square, and V1 value also given 0.15 meter cube. The M value is given as 0.18 kilogram, and the gas constant R value, that's why we are going to find. That then T1, the temperature, the initial temperature is 15 degree, is 2288 Kelvin. By substituting all the values, you will get the value of R, 0.2894 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin, right? Okay, after that, for finding the value of gamma, it is very important. It is very important to look at all the relations, PV relation, PVT relations. That is very important. Look at the PVT relation for the adiabatic process. When we are looking out the PVT relationship for adiabatic process, P1 by P2 is equal to V2 by V1 power gamma, or T1 by T2 is equal to V2 by V1 power gamma minus 1, or T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So from this three equation, you can use any suitable equation for a specific problem. So in our problem, both the pressure and the volume has given. So therefore, the first equation P1 by P2 is equal to V2 by V1 power gamma is a suitable one for solving this problem. Yes, so therefore I have taken P1 by P2 is equal to V2 by V1 power gamma is equal to P1 value is given as 100, P2 value is 400 is equal to V2 value is 0.056 divided by V1 value is 0.15 meter cube the whole power gamma. Therefore 100 divided by 400, 0.25 is equal to 0.056 divided by 0.15. 0.373 power gamma. So remember this thing, for making the power into the product, of the equation, have to take log on both sides. Here our aim is to find the value of gamma, right? The gamma is available in the power of the right hand side. To make the power into the product of the specific equation, you have to take log on both sides. So by taking log on both sides, log 0.25 is equal to log 0.373 power gamma. When we are taking log, the power automatically comes as a product of the same right hand side. Therefore, log 0.25 is equal to gamma into log 0.373. Now, by using the calculator, you can put log 0.25. There will be a value you will get, and log 0.373. So, therefore, the only one unknown is gamma. From that, you can find the value of gamma, 1.4057. Therefore, the value for gamma we found as 1.4057. Gamma is a ratio of specific heat. There will not be any unit because it is a ratio. Ratio of Cp and Cv. There is no unit for gamma. Gamma is nothing but the ratio of specific heat, or we can say adiabatic index. Okay. Then, second question. The change in internal energy delta U. Okay. Look at the formula page. What is the delta U, the internal change in internal energy for the adiabatic process? That is MCV T2 minus T1. For enthalpy also, MCP T2 minus T1. Whatever. Suppose if the work done may ask in this problem, you can find the work done by using this formula also. P1 V1 minus P2 V2 by gamma minus 1. Right here in this problem, they have asked to find the change in internal energy formulas MCV T2 minus T1. MCV T2 minus T1. Okay, so here we have used some different forms. MCV, listen carefully, MCV T2 minus T1. But in this problem, we doesn't know the value of the final temperature T2. We doesn't know about the temperature T2. We don't know. And also CV value, don't know. It won't given in the problem. So therefore, two unknowns, we are facing a difficulty. There is a two unknown in the equation. Delta U is equal to MCV T2 minus T1. So therefore, we are finding another way to find the value of delta U by first law of thermodynamic for a closed system. Q is equal to W plus delta U. That is, for any process, when we are transferring the heat to the system, along with the work, its stored internal energy also generated. So therefore, Q is equal to W plus delta U. By using this equation, we are going to find the value of delta U. For that, Q value, we don't know. W value, we don't know. So by finding the value of Q and W alone, we can find the value of delta U. As you know that, as I already told you, for the adiabatic process, there will not be any heat transfer taking place. Therefore, Q is equal to 0 for the adiabatic process. Therefore, Q is 0. We can leave the value of Q as 0. Then we have to find the value of W. So, in the formula page itself, we have found the formula for W. P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by gamma minus 1. So, here P1 value is given in the problem. V1 value is given in the problem. P2 value is given in the problem. And V2 also given in the problem. Divided by the gamma value we have found in the previous step. 1.4057 minus 1. So, therefore, all the values are known. By using that equation, we can find the value of W is equal to minus 18.24 kilojoules. Where the minus sign indicates the work is given to the system. If the W will comes as positive, that is work is done by the system. But where the W is negative, therefore the work is done on the system. We are giving the work to the system. That's why the negative sign indicates. Here, okay, we found the value of W as minus 18.24 kilojoule. Then applying the formula Q is equal to W plus delta U, where Q is equal to 0 for the adiabatic process, already we have discussed. Therefore, 0 is equal to minus 18.24 plus delta U. Therefore, delta U is equal to plus 18.24 kilojoule. So, therefore, the answer, the ratio of specific heat, gamma, is equal to 1.4057. And change in internal energy, delta U is equal to 18.24 kilojoule. So, this is the problem based on the adiabatic compression process. You have to remember some key points to solve this problem. First, you remember, for the adiabatic process, there will not be any heat is transferred. There will not be any heat transfer taking place. Therefore, consider Q is equal to 0 for the adiabatic problem. The second thing is, if any unknown value is in the power of any equation, you have to take log on both sides. When we are taking log, the power in this equation becomes the product of the same equation. Then, suppose if you are facing any difficulty, any more number of unknown in an equation, we have to try another way. Since we have taken delta U formula here, delta U is equal to MCV T2 minus T1. So, we have faced the problem as we have two different unknowns present in the same equation. So, because of that, we move on to another equation called first law of thermodynamic, Q is equal to W plus delta U. So, by finding all the suitable or available values, we found the value of delta U. Then, the steady flow equation problem, that is the application to the closed system we have seen here. The application to the open system of the first law can see in the next part. Thank you, everyone.